porcelain lizards? They look new, out of place with the rest of this old beat-up stuff.
Are you prepared to suffer to save your son? You have 5 minutes to cut off the last section of one of your fingers in front of the camera. If you succeed, you will get your reward.
I have to go through with it. I have no choice, for Sean's sake.
You have 4 minutes and 30 seconds left.
I can't cut off my own finger. I just can't do it. I want to save Sean. I'd do anything. Anything but that. I might just be able to get through this if I make the right choices. There's got to be a way to do this.
You have 3 minutes and 30 seconds left. Under the desk.
That's affirmative, Lieutenant. We're in position.
Perfect. Nobody moves until I give this signal. Is that clear? We nail him as soon as he sets foot outside.
Right, Lieutenant.
Lucky that patrol spotted his car.
What's he doing in there?
Beats me. You're the profiler, right? I thought you were supposed to be right inside the killer's head.
Well, that's just it. What I know of Ethan Mars doesn't match the killer's psychological profile.
I know what the jury's gonna choose between your theories and concrete proof. What the fuck is that girl doing there? If Mars comes out now, she's gonna be in trouble.
What do we do, Lieutenant? Wanna get her out?
No, stand down. Going inside. Maybe she lives there. Us just as well. We don't want anyone hanging around if Mars comes out.
Ethan, what happened? The police. They're out there. I think they're here to arrest you. We've got to find another way out.
Shit. What's he up to in there?
A solution.
Go on my
There's
word.
Gotta be a solution. He looks bad. What happened? No point in trying to get upstairs. Dead end on the roof. We'd be trapped.
Ready on my go. Stay here, Jayden.
Out of the question. I'm coming with you.
Two men at the door, hold your positions. It's a go.
Come on, let's go this way.
Downstairs, they're in the alley. Follow them.
The subway.
Don't move or I'll shoot.
I'm not here to judge you, Ethan. I'm trying to save the life of your son. We still have time, but it's running out. Help me, Ethan. Tell me what you know. I'm sure you had your reasons for doing what you did. You didn't think you were doing any harm. You just wanted the pain to go away. I'll help explain all that to the judge. Don't let Sean die. Tell us what you know, and we can still save him. Look at these, Ethan. Look at these. 8 photographs. 8 lives taken. Drowned in the goddamn rain. Recognize this one, huh? That's your son, Ethan. That's Sean. He is still alive. Talk to me, Ethan. Say something! You've lost, Ethan. What will you gain with one more victim? Huh?
I kidnapped my son. But I can't remember what happened. I don't know where he is. But the only way to find him is to let me out of here. I'm the only person who can save him.
You say you can save him, but you don't know where he is. That doesn't make sense, Ethan.
I love my son. I love my son. If you keep me here, Sean is going to die.
Time's running out, Ethan. And frankly, I don't care why you did it. The only thing I want to know is where you've hidden Sean.
I don't know. I would already have saved him if I knew where he was.
Okay. This is your last chance, Ethan. And this time, I suggest you think carefully before you answer. Where is Sean?
I told you, I don't know.
Ah! If you beat him, his confession's worthless. Now throw the case out. Blake, what are you doing?
This guy's a killer. He's got no fucking rights. He's gonna tell me everything. You fuck! Are you gonna tell me?
Carter, stop. I'm gonna report you for this.
Go ahead! Get the hell out of here! I couldn't stand you from the very beginning, Norman! Now get the fuck out!
That is not the way it's gonna go. I'm gonna tell the whole story to Captain Perry. That bastard is gonna beat a confession out of Mars. He just wants a culprit, even if it's the wrong guy. Fuck! That asshole has gone too far this time.
Thank you. Your vodka, sir.
Thanks.
You look preoccupied, if you don't mind my saying so. Problems with the investigation?
Blake is convinced that Mars is the killer.
Not you. I thought there was some evidence to that effect.
That's true. But it just doesn't make sense. His psychological profile doesn't fit. Neither does the geolocalization. I can't see this father drowning 8 victims before kidnapping his own kid. Mars is not the Aragami killer. I'd stake my life on it.
Then who is?
I haven't the faintest fucking idea.
Maybe you should review the evidence in your possession.
That's just what I was thinking of doing.
Oh, one last thing, sir. You should be careful not to overindulge in you-know-what. It can be dangerous. Very dangerous.
I'm trying to keep a handle on it, but that's difficult. It gets more and more difficult.
It'll end up killing you if you're not careful. That would be most unfortunate, sir.
Clue. Anything. Oh, I'm sure it's staring me in the face. Perhaps, sir, you should have another look at your clues.
There is always a railroad line adjacent to where the bodies are found. And all the victims disappeared in the fall. Well, well. Looks like there's something new.
The video recording from near the park on the afternoon Sean Mars disappeared. I doubt there's anything on it, but you never know. A Chevrolet model corresponding to the tire prints passed at 1602 heading for the park, when in the opposite direction at 1637. That could fit the time that Sean Mars disappeared. Could it be the killer's car? Ah, pity we can't see the driver's face. The car was stolen. Let's see, a certain Jackson Neville was suspected of stealing it, but the charges were dropped. Not enough evidence. Jackson Neville, aka Mad Jack, involved in several cases of buying and selling stolen vehicles. Considered to be very dangerous. This guy might have provided the killer with a car. It's a pretty slim lead, but it's all I have right now.
Did Mars confess?
No, not yet. He lost consciousness. We'll give him a break and then we'll get back to him.
He must be tougher than I thought.
Tough or not, he'll crack. They all do.
In any case, congratulations, Lieutenant. You've done a fine job. I've called a press conference. Gonna kick off in 1 hour. I expect it to be quite an event.
Don't you want to wait until we actually got his confession?
No point. We've got him dead to rights. That's all the press wants to know.
Ethan Mars is innocent. He truly believes that he alone can save Sean. What if he's right? I'll play those odds. I got to get him out of here. I gotta find some way to get Ethan Mars out of here. Even if there's only a 1 in 1,000 chance he's telling the truth, he may still be able to save his son. He may be guilty. He's acting odd, his statements are all confused, and heck, he never said he wasn't the Origami Killer. It's none of my business. If Perry and Blake think Mars is the killer, what can I do about it?
Has he confessed?
Not yet.
I see. Leave us alone.
Lieutenant Blake said to...
Please. Leave us alone.
Right. I'll be at the door if you need anything.
Christ! Are you all right, Ethan?
I gotta get out of here. I've gotta save my son.
Let's see what I can do. Should be able to get him out of here without being noticed.
shit!
What am I doing? Helping a suspect to escape? That'll cost me my badge and earn me a 10-year stretch.
Gary, you can take a break. I'll keep an eye on him.
You sure? Actually, I was busting for a piss. If you need to adjust his handcuffs, the keys are on my desk.
First, get rid of the cuffs.
Thank you.
Ethan, put this on. You might be able to get by them without being noticed. Oh shit, the handcuffs. I forgot about that. Okay, hold tight. That's it. You're free. Here, put this on. They're having a break. If you're quick, you'll be able to slip out without being noticed. Head straight to the exit. Don't stop, don't talk, don't even think. Just walk.
I don't know what to say.
Just say you're gonna save your son.
Less than an hour ago, we heard from the police who have identified the man thought to be the Origami Killer. Ethan Mars, father of the kidnapped victim Sean Mars, is on the run and should be considered armed and dangerous. A police manhunt is now underway, and they hope that they will soon be able to announce the apprehension of this dangerous lunatic.
I brought some food. I didn't know what you liked, so I brought some of everything. I hope that's okay.
You followed me.
I wanted to know. You're all over the news reports, Ethan. Every cop in the country will be hunting you. They say you're the Origami Killer. Is it true? Are you the killer, Ethan?
I don't know. I don't know. But I'm the only one who can save Sean. For your own safety, Madison, I think you should go.
Go? Ethan, they're after me too. They've seen my face. I'm in this too deep to stop now.
I sometimes have these blackouts. Times where I don't know what I'm doing. As if I'm someone completely different. The only thing I remember afterwards is the bodies. The bodies in the water.
Why are you hurt, Ethan? Why were you in that apartment?
I think my other self is testing me, testing my love for Sean. He wants to know if I love my son enough to save him. That means there's some part of me that knows where Sean is,
But the only way to find him is to go through these trials.
Why can't you tell that to the police?
And tell them what? That I'm a schizophrenic who drowns his victims and has kidnapped his own son? They'd never let me go, and I have to stay free to save Sean. I have no choice. I'm his only chance. When Sean is out of danger, I'll turn myself in, but not until then.
You can't keep going like this. You're destroying yourself, Ethan.
Finding Sean is the only thing that matters.
There has to be another way.
You don't understand. Time is running out. Sean will be dead in a few hours. I have no choice!
Please, Madison, leave. Forget everything that's happened. There is nothing more you can do for me. If you want to help me, leave. Leave me to do this on my own.